Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to talk about how you can analyze basic jitter measurements using histograms and measurement trends. So the first thing we're going to look at today is plotting the measurement trend of your time interval error. And we covered time interval error in last week's video and in the blog post, so check those out if you don't know what that means. So let's just get right into it. I'm going to turn on a math channel and plot how my time interval error changes over time. And you can see now that this math waveform is showing a sinusoidal signal. So what does this mean? If this is my ideal edge, my actual edge is kind of marching back and forth regularly around my ideal edge. So that tells me there's probably something in my system causing that to happen. So to figure out what's causing that edge to march back and forth, we want to look at the frequency of that measurement trend. So I can either take an FFT of that waveform or I can measure the frequency using my measurements. So you can see that the frequency measurement is 100 kilohertz. So you can bet that if you see this on your system, you're going to have something running at 100 kilohertz, and it may be a power supply, it might be another clock or data line, but you'll know right away that's what's causing this jitter on your signal. The other tool we like to use when looking at jitter on oscilloscopes is a histogram. So let's look at a histogram on this noisy clock signal. So to do that, I'm gonna first scroll over a couple edges so I'm not looking at my trigger point, and then I'm gonna zoom way in on one of these edges. And then to draw a histogram, all I have to do is draw a box. And I say histogram, and we're gonna give that about 15 seconds. I'm gonna modify my histogram just a little bit because I want that box to be as skinny as possible. The reason I want the box pretty skinny for my histogram is because the way it works is anytime the signal edge goes through that box, it's gonna plot it to the histogram. And I'm slowly building up a probability distribution function of where that edge is gonna align in time. Now, if we think back to what our jitter trend looked like, this histogram is gonna correspond to exactly how we expect a sinusoidal probability distribution function to look like. If we only had random jitter on our system, we would just see one Gaussian point. But because it's a sinusoidal, we actually see 2 points in my histogram, and there's definitely some random tail around that, so there's still random jitter involved. But because this is what we call a bimodal histogram, we know that there's some deterministic jitter inherent in my signal. Thanks for watching this week's episode of the 2-Minute Guru. I know that was a lot to digest really fast, so you can check out the blog post below, read through some of these topics fleshed out in a little more detail. Also, subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel. That's how you let me know that you like these videos, you like what we're doing. Hit the share button if this video was helpful, and I will see you next week. Thanks for watching.